Today you will be studying the active transport of glucose across the wall of the small intestine. You will test the effects of temperature and the availability of sodium ions and ATP on this transport. Prepare beakers labeled 1 through 4 according to your lab manual. Each beaker will contain an experimental environment into which you will place an intestinal sac. Beakers 1, 3, and 4 will be placed in a 37-degree water bath. Beaker 2 will go into an ice bath. All beakers will be aerated using gang valves. Make sure that all of these things are in place before you prepare your intestine. A segment of mouse intestine will be provided. The most challenging task for you today will be the process of everting this segment, or turning it inside out. Fill a syringe with Mammo-Ringer's 15 millimolar glucose solution. Attach the feeding tube to the syringe and insert the tube into one end of the intestinal segment. Find the black line near the bottom of this tube and slide one end of the intestine far enough up the tube so that only about 0.5 centimeter of tissue remains beneath this line. Now wrap some suture around the intestine and tube just above this dark line. Tie securely with a double knot. The goal here is to make sure that the two holes at the bottom of the feeding tube are inside the intestine once you have turned it inside out. Next, you will use your thumb and forefinger to gently slip the intestine over itself. Gently grasp the intestine just above the knot, slide it down over the knot, and release. Repeat this procedure until the entire intestine is turned inside out but remains attached to the end of the feeding tube. From this point on, do not touch the everted intestine except by the sutures you are about to attach. Now tie another double knot at the open end of the intestine. Gently begin to dispense the solution from the syringe. Tie off the first segment about 2 centimeters above the first knot, leaving some excess suture attached for handling. Tie another suture about 0.5 centimeter above this. This will create some space between your first and second intestinal sacs. At this time, you can cut the intestine between the two sacs and place the first sac into the appropriate beaker. Leave excess suture draped over the edge of the beaker. Continue this process up the length of the intestine, placing each new sac immediately into the appropriate aerated beaker. If you discover any leaks from the intestine, tie off the leaky section and do not use it for your experiment. Leave all sacs to incubate this way for 1 hour. During this incubation time, you should produce your glucose standard curve. Follow the simple steps in the lab manual and remember the following things. The glucose assay is a multi-step procedure. At the end of each step, all tubes should contain the same amount of fluid. If your tubes are not level, they do not contain the right amount of something, and you will need to start over. Zero the spectrophotometer between each step using a blank. You will use the same blank throughout the entire lab, so do not discard it between experiments. Wipe all test tubes clean with a Kim wipe before inserting them into the spectrophotometer. Do not discard any of your tubes until you have produced an acceptable curve. After 1 hour of incubation, you will empty the contents of each sac into a tube. Follow the instructions in your lab manual to combine the test solutions with the right amount of DNS reagent and distilled water in a labeled test tube. Place these tubes in boiling water for 5 minutes to bring about the color change. When the tubes are cool, add another 5 milliliters of distilled water to each. Measure absorbance in the spectrophotometer and use your standard curve to extrapolate the concentration of glucose in each sample. Please dispose of all solutions containing either DNS or DNP in the appropriate waste container. Rinse all beakers and test tubes and leave them upside down to dry.